Hey everyone, this is Tamil again, and I am back with another WordPress tutorial. So in today's video, I want to show you how you can change the font color inside of your WordPress website. So I'm sure you've seen this before where people have different color font on their website, such as this right here, or maybe they just have their brand color font that stands out a lot and it just makes their blog post look absolutely great. So if you want to learn how you can do that, then I'm going to show you right now how you can change up your font so that it can stand out, kind of like this right here. So one of the things that I like to do is use my brand colors, and I think that they really make the post stand out a lot. And it really makes them look, you know, vibrant. But one of the things I want to do is I want to make everything look good. So as you can see right here, I have my regular text as a extremely lighter color gray. And then I've got this nice bolded color blue because blue is part of one of my brand colors. So my brand colors are blue and black. So I like to play around with color like that. So let me show you right now how you can change the color to your text so that you can have that type of website that really stands out and brand yourself. So let's jump right in. All right, so here I am on the dashboard. So if you are logged into WordPress, what you want to do is you want to go over here to the left and you want to scroll down to where it says appearance. Once you see appearance, go over to the right and go to customize. Now, once you are in customize right here, you will see these different type of things that you can click on. They're really just going to take you to different pages. So they're links. You want to scroll down until you see this right here where it says color and typography settings. And that is what you would typically want, is color and typography settings. You can go ahead and click on that. And then that is going to take you to some more drop downs. And we're going to click on single post page. We're going to click on that. And then we're going to click one more time on post and page content. And so that's going to bring us to this right here. Now, this is the area that really controls a lot of the font size, the font colors for certain areas on your page. So you're going to notice inside WordPress, everything is broken down into certain sections. So you have things like the post teaser text, and that text is usually just the text that is on the main page. And so if you go to the main page of a post, it usually gives like teaser text. So if I go back a page, it gives this text right here. It's just like the teaser. It just gives you like the first line or two. That's the color of that text. So that's what you would call like the teaser text. And so you can begin to change that font color, because that font color is really going to be also too a part of the main font page. So if you click on this, you can change it to whatever you want. So if you want bolded black, you can change it to black, red, green, purple. It really doesn't matter. I keep mine very simple. I like the lighter gray color. So you can pretty much change the font color to that. And also too, if you want to get into the font size and you want to make your font size bigger, you can also do that as well. Now we're going to scroll down a little bit, because as you can see right here, you see the post text. And then if you look down and you keep looking, you're going to go past the line height, you're going to see body and post text color. So this is the color that I use for the body of my post. And so it is just this plain color right here. You can click on it and you can change the color if you want. You can change, like you can see right here, if you want it to be black, you can change it to black. You can change it to whatever color that you want, but that's going to be the body of the post. Now, there are some things that you can customize, such as your post link color and the border colors. I'm going to go back here and I'm just going to show you some of those, because if I click on this page again, or this is for my blog post, then I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to start showing you some things which is actually going to link into like the H1 and the H2 colors, but you'll be able to see that as well. So as I scroll down, I can do certain things like this, which is not H1 at all. This will allow you to change the color. So if you go back here and you have post link color, you just need to know what is going to change. So we have post link border colors and then post link hover colors. So hover is if you hover over anything, usually it will change a color. And I'm going to show you how that works with the social media posts in a second. But now as we scroll down and we get to the H1, which is heading one, and the H2 fonts, you will see I already have them set for black, and I have them that way on purpose just because I want them to stay bolded. But for H3, I have it set for blue. So I'm just going to show you what that looks like. So as I scroll down, because I have it as third one right here, under build your list, which is my H3, I have as blue. And you'll see that as I scroll down, I have some extra subheadings that I'm keeping as gray. So you just really need to know where your H1s and your H2s are going to be at, because those will easily be whatever color you want. So I have those H3s and 4s, I believe, as blue. So now as you scroll down, I have other ones here too. H6 is going to be black, and some other colors will be black. Now I want to show you this right here. Continue reading link. This right here is typically on the main page. I'm going to go all the way back to the home page. Okay, so here I am on the home page, and this is typically on the home page of any site. If you scroll down to one of the posts, you'll see this continue reading section. So as you can see, when I hover over this, it turns blue, and you can have that for any of the ones that you have. So maybe you want it to be red or green or purple or whatever your brand color is, but once you hover over it, you can actually change the color to it. So that's what this will do for you right here. If I scroll up to the continue reading right here, the font color is black, but if I hover over it, it's green, it's blue. So you can change your font color. So this is really just customizing. This is going not just beyond font, but you can customize pretty much anything that you want. So this is the typical way that you can customize all of your fonts, just knowing what you're looking at, because everything has a font style and a font color. So you just need to know, and it takes a little bit of time. You may have to go to some of your posts. You may have to look at what you have. For example, if you're looking at this post right here that I have, I can click on it and I just have to look to see what's what. So this main page, this is black. If I click on it, just hovering over, that's my pop-up, just hovering over things to see what does what. So say for example, I have these social media icons right here that I can click on. If I hover over it, like Pinterest, I could have turned it red. If I hovered over this, I could have turned it black. If I hovered over Facebook, I could have changed it to orange. But I like my brand colors right here, so this is pretty much how this looks. But I'm going to show you how you can even change these colors, you know, since I'm already working on this. Now that we have an understanding about font colors, you can customize this pretty much however you want. It's just a matter of what you want to do. This is where you would go to do so. I want to show you how you can make it over to your social media colors. So I'm going to go back one, and then I'm going to go back another one. You got to keep going back, of course. And we're going to go back to this very main page, which is pretty much the first page where you see the colors and typography settings. And if you look up here, you'll see social media settings. If you click on that, you can go up to the top and click on social share buttons. And when you do that, you will have the option here of changing all of the icon colors. So it says social share buttons. Like I said, I keep mine basic and blue because I like to stick with my brand colors. But you can actually click on this, like the border hover and the background hover. You can click on them and just change them to whatever you want. So this is about as easy as you can, you know, get it, and for your social media. And I like to keep mine very, very simple. That's just me. That's what I like to do. All right. So give me a thumbs up if you like this video. And also let me know down in the comment section below if you found this very useful and if this really helped you out. And lastly, guys, make sure that you check out some of the other videos that I have on my channel, such as granting a user access to your website. Now, if you just do not feel like doing any of this work, you can definitely get someone else to do the work for you, and you can just grant that user access to your website, and you can pretty much get all of the same results. So guys, let me know down in the comment section below what you're doing with your blog and how these tutorials are working out for you. I'm constantly putting out WordPress tutorials on a consistent basis, and I am constantly teaching you guys how to build your business online. So if you are using a blog or, you know, WordPress to build your audience, then this is definitely the place for you. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video.